Alright, what's up guys? Today's video, I'm gonna be fixing up these door side panels on my car.
Ew.
They're pretty bad. On this side it's starting to rust, on the other side it's just peeling. But I'm gonna test out three different variations of how you can fix the side door panel. First variation I'm gonna try is this matte black vinyl. I got it online, pretty cheap, but we're gonna try that one out on the back. The second variation I'm gonna try out is this trim and bumper paint. I think it's gonna be a little more glossy, requires a little bit more work, but we'll see if it has a better finish. The last variation I'm gonna try is the all famous Plasti-Dip. Kinda, you know, a cheaper way to spray it, but we're gonna test out these three variations, see which one's best. I'm gonna start off with the vinyl. So let's get on to the tools you're gonna need and how we're gonna do that. First step whenever you're gonna be doing the vinyl is just to get your vinyl, do a rough cut. You can measure it out, cut it out, rough cut, so you're not wasting all this extra vinyl whenever you're putting it on. Next, you're gonna take your sandpaper. I have 1,000 grit sandpaper, but 400 to 600 grit should be fine. I'm just gonna have to scrub more, but you're gonna sand off this area, make it nice and smooth to the touch. So the important thing here whenever you're sanding is just to make sure it's smooth. You don't have to worry about color or anything. I still feel a little bump right here. Just making sure to keep it wet also just helps with the smoothness. But yeah, as long as you feel that bump in there, just keep sanding. All right, so I got it now to where it's smooth to the touch all the way up. Next step,
you're gonna take your alcohol and microfiber towel cloth, just clean off this area, clean it off really good, just to make sure there's nothing in between the vinyl and the part you're putting the vinyl onto. Now, right after you've cleaned it off with the alcohol, you're gonna start peeling off your vinyl at the top, stick it to it, and then peel all the way down using your Bondo card just to make it as flat as possible. You just peel it back up, push it down just to make it flat.
I got a couple bubbles in here, so I'm gonna peel it up, push it back on. This all looks pretty good though. All right, so I painstakingly messed up on this part down here. It wasn't smooth enough. Now 90% of painting or putting vinyl on is sanding down, making sure it's smooth. So just make sure you do that so you don't have to mess up and get another sheet like me. All right, so once you've got it good, like how you want it, make sure you use your nail or something hard to indent these lines.
Now once you've got it smooth enough all the way down on the vinyl, you're gonna take your knife and do the exact cuts. You could put it on a piece of rubber or something. Just make sure not to cut on any glass or anything, but just tuck it in, get a nice clean cut on the edge, and then you're done.
Yes. Let me just peel this off. Okay, peel it out, and you're good on that side. And just make sure all of this stuff is pushed in. All right, so I got this side done. I will be straight up with y'all. I think this is more closely to the original color of what it was, which is good. It was hard to stick them, hard to keep the vinyl around the corners, but you just take your Bondo card or knife and you're able to poke those around the corners. And down here was a little tricky. Got cut once or twice and there's like a bubble or two. Not too bad, looks pretty good though. We're gonna move on to the spray paint now. And yeah. Rust is nasty. Whenever you're taping across the edge right here, one way that you can get a nice line right where you want to paint it is you just push the tape in like so, and then you can cut off the excess pieces, get right there in that groove, and peel off this tape, and you're all good to go. Cleaned it off with some alcohol. Now we're gonna let it dry. Put some Plasti-Dip on it. All right, let's start Plasti-Dipping. It's looking pretty good for the first coat. Now I'm gonna spray a second coat and let it dry again. The third coat has dried. You can notice that it's textured because it's sprayed, at least compared to this vinyl over here. I saw this one thing where you put paint thinner on your finger and you rub it. It's supposed to loosen up the paint, make it all smooth, put it all on the same level. So I'm gonna try that now, see if it really works or not. Just rub this top part right here. I can feel it start to smoothen out though after I rub it a few times. Yes, you can actually see it does. Even makes it a little shiny right there. Oh, we're gonna test this one out. We just gotta sand that, prep it to paint, and then we'll compare the three. All right, guys, I'm finally done sanding. It's all smooth, finally. Now for the final test. So for this last side, I'm gonna do the trim and bumper paint, but I'm probably gonna be doing 1 to 2 coats of the primer first, and then we can compare all three. I got the first coat of primer dried. I'm gonna go ahead and wet sand it now. Way to know that you're actually sanding it, or if you miss a spot or not. Whenever you sand the primer, it gets darker. So any spots like up here that's pretty light, you just wanna go ahead, hit it, it'll turn darker, and then you know that you sanded it. All right, I think that's as good as I'm getting. Don't mind that spot right there. Never happened. But I'm gonna take this. I'm gonna take this trim and bumper paint, and we're gonna spray it on. See how it does. All right, I feel like that's a good first good base coat. PSA to anyone, fix your primer before moving on. That's gonna be in there. So I honestly don't personally mind it, but just for y'all, make sure to fix your primer. So that's the first coat of the trim and bumper paint. We're gonna go ahead, wet sand it real quick. Don't wet sand the actual trim and bumper paint. All right, second coat is dried. I'm gonna put the third and final coat on here, and we'll see how it looks after 20 minutes. Oh, okay. I don't know if y'all can see it, but, oh yeah, right there. And my fingerprint, sexy. All right, we'll give it 20 minutes. After 5 long hours of doing this, y'all have already seen that one. We're gonna reveal, we saw the plastic dip side versus spray painted side. So of course, like I thought, it was gonna be more glossy. I didn't really want the glossy, so I didn't do it the best. Only one coat of, primer, thank you. I don't know. If you do it well and stuff and you like the glossy appeal, definitely go for it, but do it right. I like the plastic dip way more. I'm gonna have to go over it again because of that thing, but went ahead and also plastic dip this top part. I think it looks way better, but here's the close-ups of everyone. So 1 compared to 2. And then compared to the vinyl. I mean, if you wanna go ahead and do vinyl, it's way easier. You don't have to tape up anything. You just have to sand it, clean it with alcohol, and then you're good. So for me, honestly, I think vinyl's the best. It's the easiest, quickest way to do it. Next would be plastic dip. I like plastic dip, but yeah. And then third would be the trim if you do it right. But I don't really like the glossy, so tomorrow I'm probably gonna sand it down, spray it with plastic dip. But I mean, it looks way better than what it looked like before. But yeah, thank y'all, hope y'all appreciated it. That was a lot, so see y'all on the next one.